Good evening, I'm Jim Williams. For the second straight day, more than 2,000 people in Illinois have tested positive for COVID-19. The Illinois Department of Public Health announced 2,119 new cases today, bringing the total in the state to 41,177. 80 more people lost their lives, bringing the total number of deaths in Illinois to 1,874. CBS2's Mike Puccinelli is live at the Thompson Center. Mike, despite those numbers, there's some backlash to stay-at-home orders.
That's right, Jim. As those numbers you just wrote off indicate, the numbers continue to skyrocket right now in the state of Illinois. But despite that, some people are agitating for the economy to be partially reopened in less than a week. Now, that's how it looked this morning in Crest Hills. We show some video to you right now where a group of protesters gathered to demand that the governor release a plan to cautiously return to work by May 1st. A shouting match erupted when a counter protester showed up. Now, the protest southwest of the city coincides with a lawsuit against the governor by State Representative Darren Bailey. Now, in his suit, he maintains that the governor overextended his power when he issued additional stay-at-home orders, extending the initial order, which expired earlier this month. Bailey, who's from a tiny southern Illinois town, says he and his constituents are ready to go back to work and resume a normal life. But the governor says it's not that simple.
I absolutely recognize the difference between rural areas and the number of infections that are happening there versus urban areas. But again, this virus knows no boundaries. It isn't saying to itself, I'm going to go after people in an urban area. It simply can get transmitted anywhere.
Now, the governor responded specifically to the lawsuit, saying it is truly unfortunate that a legislator is working against our public health efforts, end quote. Now, today's news conference marked the 47th straight day where the governor went before the cameras to talk about the COVID-19 crisis in Illinois. Reporting out live at the Thompson Center, Mike Puccinelli, CBS 2 News. Jim?
Mike, thank you.